So good morning all. Today we will start with the congestion control. In the previous lecture we have studied the flow control and error control. So with the connection with that topic or combination of that topic, that is the next topic is a congestion control. So all our dreams can come true if you have the courage to pursue them. Okay, so Walt Disney, so very nice thought. So Walt Disney is the American producer or writer. I think you have know the Disney World. So he has directed so many, produced so many movies like Cinderella. I hope you've seen in your childhood. Okay, so he said very nice thought. All our dreams can come true if you have the courage to pursue them. Okay, so let's start with our today's topic. So data traffic. First, exactly we understand what is the data traffic. Suppose I am taking very real time example. Suppose you are moving to Pune to Mumbai, right? You are going to Pune to Mumbai, and in between the middle there is a Mahad, and there will be a lot of traffic in the Mahad. So there is nothing but what? So from Mumbai side to Pune and Pune side to Mumbai, so both the side there is a congestion. Okay, so that is nothing but the lot of traffic. So that is nothing but the congestion. So how we can control that traffic? Okay, so suppose the in between morning 9 to 10 there is a lot of traffic. Okay, so sometime in the middle or in the afternoon there is a less traffic, or in the evening there is a more traffic. So we have to control the congestion by making the congestion control. How that congestion can be controlled in actual our data communication, okay, in a internet communication, how exactly that we are going to control, we have to see in the chapter, okay, or in this topic. So how exactly the data traffic, that I would explain you. The main focus of the congestion control and the quality of the service is a data traffic. In a congestion control, we try to avoid the traffic congestion. In quality of service, we try to create the appropriate environment for the traffic. So before talking about the congestion control and quality of the service, we discuss the data traffic itself. So that real-time example, Pune-Mumbai example, that I will explain you here in the concern with the data traffic. So we'll first discuss a traffic descriptor and traffic profiles. So you can see here the traffic descriptors. So here we can see in the x-axis, that is the seconds, and here is data rate. Okay, so how exactly how much data we can transfer. So you can see as soon as second goes on increasing, okay, you can see here. So in this part there is a average data rate. Okay, so there is a average data rate. So here there is a maximum bus size. So means there is nothing but the lot of data can be transferred in the duration towards the or into the network. And the peak data rate. So this is nothing but what? The peak data rate. So that it cannot be sent more than this. So that is nothing but the capacity of that traffic or capacity of that transmission way. So that much data you can send. You cannot send the data more than this. Then there should be a congestion. Okay, there is nothing but the more traffic. So you can see that there are three traffic profiles. So first we will discuss this traffic. So we can nothing but the constant bit rate. Okay, so with the data rate and time, so we are sending the data with the constant speed. So when from sender to receiver, so there is nothing but the transmission of the bit in a same rate. So in the next diagram you can see variable bit rate. So might be in the morning there will be the less data, in the afternoon there is a more data, again in the evening there is a less data. So there is nothing but the variation in the transmission of the data. I am taking one example according with the time. And you can see here the bus T. Bus T means suppose you go into the Pune and you can go into the Hinjawadi. If you go in the morning 9 to 11, you should be we can say there is a bursting of, or there is a burst of the data, nothing but the burst of the bikes, cars, everything. There is a too much traffic, so too much congestion. If you go in the afternoon, no one is wandering on the road, right? Again in the evening there is again the big traffic. So that is nothing but what? With the time frame there is change in the data rate. Similarly you can see here, this is the bursty mode. So in the initial starting position there is a lot of data, in the middle there is no data, again in the end of the time there is again the data. So there is nothing but the blocks of the data, means in certain time there is a lot of traffic and in certain time there is not a traffic. So that is very simple. So now we'll understand exactly what is the congestion that I will explain you, but in the technical language we will see. The congestion in a network may occur if the load on the network, the number of packets sent to the network, is greater than the capacity of the network. Okay, so the number of the packets of a network can handle, and the congestion control refers to the mechanism and techniques to control the congestion and keep the load below the capacity. So very simple. Suppose in on a road there is a one way road, so only one car can go and one car can come by the road. Okay, if you are sending the two cars at a time, and we are also from the front side there also coming the two cars at the same time, so what happened? There should be the congestion because they are not having the capacity of that road to carry the four cars at a time, right? So that much simple in the congestion. Suppose the data rate of the that line or that link should be very, or should be its capacity is somehow limited, or you are sending the over data on that, so there should be a loss of packets, or there will be a there should require the retransmission. Okay, so there is a congestion occurs and there is a no data transmission happens. So this is what the congestion. So we'll see the network performance exactly what happened in the congestion. So the congestion, the situation in which too many packets are present in the subnet. Okay, so too many present. So here we can see it is nothing but the packet sends, and this is nothing but the packet delivered. So here is a packets receivers can sender can send the packets, and receiver can receive the packet. So here it is going on very fine. Okay, sender sending packet, receiving sender sending, receiver receiving. So what happened at this limit? Okay, so this is how it is a perfect. Okay, so this is how it is perfect. So this is nothing but the perfect. We can show the maximum capacity you can send the data. Okay, so desirable, how much? This much is the desirable, and this is a congested. Okay, so what happened? So there is the receiver or packet is not get delivered. So this is nothing but the congestion in happen. So you are sending the data, but at the receiver it is not receiving. So there is the packets get congested. Okay. Now what are the problems? What are the problems behind these congestions? Okay. So first, the congestion occurs when router receives the data faster than it can send it. Okay. So I will take one example. Suppose you are two friends, okay, you are throwing the balls to your friends, okay, you are throwing the balls towards your friends, and he is catching that balls. Now you are sending first ball, second, third, fourth. Now your speed will goes on increasing, but he cannot catch your balls that much faster, so some catch are missing. The same example we are going to relate here. The senders are sending the data, okay, but the receiver is not having his capacity to receive the packets with that speed, okay, with that capacity. So some packets may go maybe get lost. Okay, so this is how the congestion occurs when the routers receives the data faster than it can send it. So insufficient bandwidth, slow host, the data simultaneously arriving from multiple lines destined for the same outgoing line. Okay, so we'll take the same example. Okay, suppose receiver he is catching the ball, and three of our friends are sending the balls, and he is simply single person catching them, so it's become very difficult to him, right, on the same line. Okay, the system is not balanced. Correcting the problem at one router will probably just move the bottleneck to the another router. Okay, so this is how the causes of the congestion. Now there are few more causes. Incoming message must be placed in the queue. Then the queue have a finite size. Overflowing queues will cause the packet to be dropped. Okay, so we are keeping these packets in the queue, but when queue get overflow, then packet will be lost. Sometime the long queue. Okay, there is a long queue means for reaching that packet to the receiver, so it take too much time, so there is a delay. So dropped packets will cause the packets to resend. Suppose few packets you are going to drop, so again that packet has to be resend. So again there is a congestion. Now senders that are trying to transmit to congested destination also become congested. Okay, so you are trying to send the data on a congested network. Again, there is a congestion, and you are sending the data again on that line. So again, there is a congestion. Okay, so they must continually resend the packets that have been dropped, that have timeout, and they must continue to hold an outgoing unacknowledged. Okay, so this is how the few causes of the congestions. Now, what exactly the congestion control versus flow control? So flow control means what? Control points to point traffic between sender and receiver. Example, fast host sending to a slow host. Suppose I am very fast and your receiving capacity is not that much, you are very slow. Okay, so that is what the flow control. But what is the congestion control? Control the traffic throughout the network from transmitter to receiver. Throughout the traffic, you have to control the network. Now, the congestion control we are going to learn here. The congestion control refers to the techniques and the mechanism that can either prevent the congestion before it happens or remove the congestion after it is happened. In general, we can divide the congestion control mechanism into two broad categories. First is open loop congestion control, and another is a closed loop congestion control. Okay, so there are two things. You can control the things before happening, and another is if the things is happen, then how to control. Okay, if the congestion should not happen, and if the congestion is happen, then what action should be taken. Okay, so there are two scenarios. So there are open loop congestion control and closed loop congestion control. They have divided into two parts. So first, in the congestion control, when one part of the subnet, one or more routers in the area become overloaded, a congestion results, because routers are receiving packets faster than they are forwarded them. One of two things must happen. Now what are the things happen? The subnet must prevent additional packet from entering the congested region until those already present can be processed. Okay, so already those packets are there, they must proceed, and then he can receive the new packets. Okay, then you can control the congestion. And the next, the congested routers can discard the queued packet to make a room of those that are arriving. Okay, so those are already packets or their congestion routers. What he can do, he can discard the queued packets. So whatever the packets in the queue, they should discard and make the rooms for, or make the space for, new packets. Now there are two categories: open loop solution and closed loop solution. So in the open loop solution, attempt to prevent the problem rather than correct them. So before happening the problem, it should prevent, and do not utilize the runtime feedback from the system. So do not use the runtime feedback. Okay, and another is a closed loop solution. Use the feedback or measurement of the system performance to make the correction at a runtime. So in the runtime, you can make the correction, or you can take the data, or you can resend it. Okay, so runtime you can do this. Now, general principle of congestion control. So analogy with the control theory, open loop and closed loop. So in open loop approach, problem is solved at the design cycle. Once the system is running, mid-course correction is not made. Okay, so before happening the problem or congestion, in open loop you can control. Once in the running system, you can not made the correction. Tools for doing the open loop control, that is deciding when they accept the new traffic, deciding when no disagreement packet, and which ones, making scheduling decision at various points in the network. Okay, this is how the 3 or 4 points you can do in the open loop approach. So first, general purpose in a closed loop approach. Okay, it is based on the principle of a feedback loop. The approach has 3 parts when specified a congestion control. So monitor the system to detect when the congestion occurs. Okay, so first we have to monitor the system exactly where the congestion is occurring. Okay, and pass this information to place where action can be taken. So pass this information exactly where the action should be taken, and adjust the system operation to correct the problem. This is how the closed loop approach is. Now we are going to see here the congestion control categories. In the open loop, retransmission policy, window policy, acknowledgement policy, discarded policy, admission policy, and in a closed loop, that is the back pressure, choke packet, implicit signaling, and explicit signaling that we are going to learn. So first we will see the warning bit and back pressure. Okay, a special bit in the packet header is set by the router to warn the source when congestion is detected. So what happened? There is a one packet we are sending in the header of the packet. When there is a congestion occurs, that router warns a source with that bit. Okay, we set that bit. Okay, so that bit can tell the sender, yes, there is a congestion occurs. So the bit is copied and piggybacked on the acknowledgement and sent to the sender. Okay, so whatever that bit, okay, that bit is copied and saved into the acknowledgement, and that acknowledgement sent to the sender. And then sender come to know, yes, there is a congestion occurs in middle between the network. Okay, now the sender monitor the number of acknowledgement packet and receive the with the warning bit sent and adjust it transmission rate accordingly. Suppose there is a congestion, so it will transmission rate will be slower if there is a congestion occurs. Okay, so next, back pressure method for elevating the congestion. Okay, so source, and here is the data flow. So there is a congestion. Okay, so there is a congestion, so there will be the back pressure on a source or previous routing components. Okay, so there is nothing but the back pressure method for alleviating the congestion. Okay, means what? This network send, this congestion occurs, so it send the acknowledgement bit to the source. Okay, so that there is a congestion in the network line. So now choke packet. So what is this choke packet is? So the choke packet, a choke point is a point sent by the router to the source to inform it to congestion. This type of control is similar to the ICMP source quench packet. Okay, a more direct way to telling the source to slow down. That is nothing but the very direct way. You can directly tell to the source, you can slow down your transmission transmission packets. A choke packet is a control packet generated at a congested node and transmitted to the restrict traffic flow. Okay, so what it can? So it send that packet to the sender, and he's told that so you can restrict the traffic flow. So you can stop your sending packets. The source on receiving this choke packet must reduce its transmission rate by certain percentage. Okay, when you receive the choke packet, then what the sender does, it slow down his transmission of the packets toward the sender. Okay, now what happened next? An example of the choke packet is the ICMP source quench packet that I already explained you. So this is how the choke packet. So here is a congestion occurs, then he send the choke packet to the source, and then his choke packet give the message that slow down your transmission. So there is a congestion, right? Now next is the open loop control. The network performance is a guarantee to all traffic flow that have been admitted into the network. So that is nothing but the key mechanism: admission control policy, traffic shaping, and traffic scheduling. So we'll see the admission control. So you can the admission control, there is a typical bit rate demanded by the variable bit information source. So this is nothing but the time and bits per second. So there is nothing but the variation in the rate of the bits sent. So this is nothing but the admission control. So what are the specific requirement of this? Peak average, minimum bit rate, maximum bus size, and delay and loss requirement. Okay, so network computer resource needed, that is nothing but the efficient bandwidth should be needed. Okay, if a flow accepted, network allocate the resources to ensure quality of service delivered as long as source confirm the contract. Okay, so this is how the admission control can be done. Now the policing. Now what are the policies? The network monitor the traffic flow continuously to ensure they meet their traffic contracts. When a packet violate the contract, network can discard or tag the packet, giving its lower priority. Okay, so there is some policies of transmission, and suppose there is some packets violating their contracts, then it keep that packet to the low priority, so you will be sent at the last. Okay, if congestion occurs, tagged packet are discarded first. Okay, so what is the meaning of this? When there is a congestion occurs, who is first get discarded? That tagged packet. Leaky bucket algorithm is the most commonly used policing mechanism. Okay, so what is this leaky bucket algorithm? So in between, you are sending the data from sender to the receiver. In between, there is we can say the buffer. In that buffer, we are sending whatever the packets are received that are stored in that buffer. If the extra packets are transmitted, that packets are stored on that buffer, and then this buffer continuously sending the data according to the receiver has the capacity. Okay. Now TCP congestion control. So TCP assumes the best effort network. So first in, first out, that is nothing but the queue, and each source determines the network capacity for itself. Use implicit feedback, acknowledgement, pace transmission. What are the challenges? So determine the available capacity in the first place and adjusting to change the availability of the capacity. So now here we are going to learn the slow start. Okay. So one of the algorithm used in the TCP congestion, this is called as a slow start. And this algorithm is based on the idea that the size of the congestion window start with one maximum segment size. Okay, that is called as a MSS. Okay, now how exactly it works? So I will simply explain you how exactly it works. First, sender send the one packet to the receiver. Okay, what it can does? First, it send the one packet to the receiver. It is called as a MSS. The MSS, that is nothing but the maximum segment size. Once it's sent, what happened next? When the acknowledgement received, then it sends the two packets. Okay, it sends the two packets. Then when he received the acknowledgement of those two packets, then he sent the three packets. If the acknowledgement of these three packets received, he sent the four packets. I hope you are understanding what I am saying. So here in the diagram, they have shown first they send the one packet, then he receives the acknowledgement, then he sends the two packets, then he receives the acknowledgement of both, then he send the three message, again he receives the acknowledgement, and likewise it goes on increasing of the packets. So that is called as the slow rate. Okay, so efficient increase the congestion window exponentially rather than linearly. Okay, so there is no linear. Okay, so not linear, so it will be exponential. Okay, slowly we are increasing the data rate. So why it is called slow? It is compared to the original behavior of the TCP, it is not a linear mechanism. So here you can see what is the now this can be used. So when first starting the connection, when connection goes dead waiting for the timeout. So okay, so you can see here the different windows, and there will be a no congestion. So every time that received packet is received acknowledgement, and then you can send the next bit. Now there is a fast transmit and fast recovery. So in the problem, now I will explain you in the diagram very simple. Before explaining this theoretical part, I will show you. Here is a sender, here is the receiver. Now I will send the packet 1, packet 2, packet 3, but you can see there is a loss of the packet 3, but still it continue sending the packet 4, packet 5, packet 6. Okay, and at the same time he is receiving the acknowledgement as well as acknowledgement of the packet 1, packet 2, packet. Okay, so acknowledgement he is receiving again for the packet acknowledgement, different acknowledgement received for the packet 4, 5, 6, but he has not received the acknowledgement of packet 3. Okay, he's not received the acknowledgement of packet 3. Then what happened? Again, he resend the packet 3. Okay, after a packet 6. Okay, then he received the acknowledgement of 6. And in between, if he received the acknowledgement of packet 3, and then he start the next 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so the transmission will be continued. There will be no delay in between that. So in between there is not received the acknowledgement of in between any packets. He again resend the that packet. Okay, and the further counting is or further packet sending is going on. This is called as the fast retransmission and fast recovery. So results of this, the long period during which the congestion windows stay flat and no packets are sent have been eliminated. So all the packets can be sent, eliminated about half of the coarse grain timeout, and the fast recovery skip the slow rate phase that happens between the when fast retransmission detects lost packet and additive increase the begin. So go directly to half the last successful. So this is how the result of the fast retransmissions. So I hope you understand the congestion control. So this is not very easy. Very easy task. So how to find the congestion, how to control it. So there are different techniques, open loop, closed loop, and retransmission, slow rate. Okay, so I hope you learn things. If you have any doubts, you can contact me or message me. So thank you very much for today's lecture.